haven't slept with him, but thank you for asking. My tits have, it's a weird time. But anyways, give it up for Marlo Franson for Marlo Franson!
Yay, you already said this right here, or you already said all the songs. Right on. So I haven't done comedy for a couple weeks, so I'm a bit rusty. So just to let you guys know, is any of you guys gonna have sex with me later on? A little FYI. Well, one lucky girl will anyways, if you're up for it. Alright. As a comedian, I'd like to introduce you to myself, but I don't have a TV and a VCR here, so I can't really pop the VCR in to say, hey, I'd like you to introduce myself to myself. It's Marlo. And unfortunately, that's a shame, because you guys would probably laugh at that, right? You know, having me on TV right there introducing myself. But unfortunately, it's not going to work, because there's no VCR here. And, oh well, right? I wish it was, because then you'd be like, wow, this is like crazy, because then I wouldn't have a goatee on it. And you're like, wow, no, it's crazy too, because, you know, that's the future, is I actually shave myself. And then I go, and then you go, oh wow, he has more hair. And then I go, yeah, is that crazy too? Because in the future, then I would have more hair, which is good because then hair restoration would work in the future, which is good because then obviously now it doesn't. luckily there's no TV and VCR here, so you don't get to see that action and distraction, anyways. But I'm also a psychic, that's right, and I knew you guys would all show up. I did. I even knew you were going to show up. What's your name? Sue? Sue, that's a great name. Next time I have a psychic vision of you, I'll be able to put your name to the face. Probably be visioning her tonight. For my horror movie. No, just kidding. Well, come on now. You'd be the damsel in distress. And that's right. And I'd be the one rescuing you. So can I have your number now? Wait. Okay. How about now? That's okay. That's weird. Hey, wait a minute. You weren't a part of my psychic vision. How'd you get in here? Security? There's probably no security here. Yeah. Was it because they asked? Didn't say anything about being gay. That's right. May cause attractions to me. Oh, I'm sorry. No, that's okay. Don't worry about it. You can stay. Close the lab. Well, that's, you know why? Because, you know what? I'm actually married, right? I married my right hand. I figured, why the hell not? Right? It does all the work. It's been there through thick and thin. It's been there for all my ups and downs. I even made my left hand the best man. You know why? Because he was always feeling left out. Seriously, what can you do with your left hand, you know? Like, it's a shameful hand. I mean, besides holding the steering wheel of a car, he's always crying. I felt like giving something, you know? He's my best man. And plus, you know, look, buddy, you can hold my drink when I'm taking a pee, right? Because I can't hold my drink with my right hand, right? When I'm peeing. So and heaven forbid you put it on the console, because as soon as that happens, all the germs will automatically get into the glass, and then your drink's contaminated. So you gotta, and your girlfriend's not gonna hold your drink too while you're peeing, is she? I mean, honey, can you come in here? Can you just hold my drink while I take a urination? My left hand's not good enough to hold the drink, so I just wanna, like, have that happen. And so, but I'm, you know, he should be happy. My left hand. My right hand's even happier. So some of you actually may think I'm familiar, but no, I'm not the terrorist from True Lies. And no, I'm not the terrorist from Collateral Damage, so what's me? Do I look like a terrorist? Do I look like I could kill someone? No, of course not. I'm just a little guy. You know, I mean, and some of you may think I've been in movies, but if I was, it'd probably be a bomb. Speaking of that, anybody want to light my fuse on my shoe? Ooh, you guys keep up with the news. Now, don't worry, we'll see that for the Olympics, right? You know, get the fireworks going then. Or how about the, or better yet, December 21st, 2012, you know, end of the world. And that would never suck, like, you know, everybody knows, right? December 21st, 2012 is the end of the world, right? So, wouldn't that suck, though, if you die the day before, you know, like, you're driving a car, you're in an accident, you die, it's like, yeah, you're up in heaven, you're like, God, like, why couldn't I live to the end of the world? It's like, sorry, stupid driving. And then, plus, you're going to go to hell anyways. He's like, what? Because you didn't worship me. You didn't visit me every Sunday. And then that would be the end of it. And then you go to hell. So that would suck, right? As you can see, I do have a weight problem. Mostly it's I can't wait to eat. No, I'm just kidding. They're actually pretty expensive. They're like $1 a pound, so if you want to buy a $200 pound weight set, that's $200. That's too expensive for me. I just gotta go to the gym and pay $15 a month for 800 years. But I've been trying to lose weight. I've changed my eating habits. I eat all my greens, right? And my cereals. So basically I feel like I'm actually, I eat a lot of bananas, so I feel like I'm a monkey. I actually have to carry around a bag of nuts with me all the time now, just to tide me over. So I feel like a squirrel as well. Which is great, because you know why they are skinny, is because when they eat that light, you're going to get skinny. And that's why I'm getting skinny, apparently. But the problem with my diet is it's hellish because I'm starving all the time. But the good thing about that is at least my food is a nice nut brown. On a sad note, I did drop my girlfriend, that's right, out of a 7-story building. Oh, I know. Off the balcony. I had to. The place was on fire. Of course, she started the fire. And I know you guys are like, how the hell did I survive that, right? And well, she broke my phone. I was lucky. A new joke right at the right time. Okay. On another note, I don't know. Have you guys seen that Days of Thunder movie? Anybody? Well, apparently there's a big uproar because he has to play a retard in the movie, right? And part of the movie he's playing in the movie, he's an actual actor in the movie, playing a retard in another movie that's in the movie. And apparently some people are up in arms about that, right? Because they're loving these people. But I'm upset because the fact is, I'm surprised that we still use that word for them. And I don't think we do. I think we've actually moved on from retard to, what was it? Well, we moved on to handicapped, right? But I know, I'm getting to it. But no, we actually called them handicapped, remember that? You can't call people retards, you have to call them handicapped. But you know what happened then? All the people in wheelchairs got all upset. They're like, well, we're handicapped, but we're not up there. And so what happened was they had to rename them to call them special needs. There you go. And I would love to have the rude retard back. Wouldn't that be the best thing in the world? You can call somebody, somebody's driving along, he's in a car accident, and it's his fault. You call him a retard. But he's not mentally challenged, he's not physically handicapped, he's just a retard. I would love that word back. And I hope one day we get that word back. So to all you people, cheer us on. Don't ever ostracize the word retard. And I'm going to give you back to Antoinette Keane. Thank you. I'm Marlo Franson. Enjoy the rest of the comedy show.
Marlo Franson! The retard king! Retarded!
You believe it.